నేను మాత్రం మా ఇద్దరు పిల్లల్ని క్వాలిటీ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అందించే ఉల్లంపర్రు మాంటిసోరీ స్కూల్లో మాత్రమే చదివిస్తాను. ఇలా అన్ని ఉన్న చోట మన పిల్లల్ని చదివిస్తేనే వాళ్ళకి మంచి భవిష్యత్తు ఉంటుంది.
నాకు అన్ని నెంబర్ 1 ఏ కావాలి. అందుకే నా పెద్ద మనవరాల్ని అన్ని వసతులతో క్వాలిటీ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అందిస్తున్న స్కూల్లోనే జాయిన్ చేశాను.
ఏ స్కూల్ సార్ అది?
ఉల్లంపర్రు మాంటిసోరీ స్కూల్. క్వాలిటీ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ లో నెంబర్ 1, కల్చరల్ యాక్టివిటీస్ లో నెంబర్ 1, స్పోర్ట్స్ లో నెంబర్ 1, క్యాంపస్ లో నెంబర్ 1.
అది
మీ పిల్లల బంగారు భవిష్యత్తుకు మాది బాధ్యత.
గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ స్టూడెంట్స్, దిస్ ఇస్ అనంత, ద టీచర్ ఆఫ్ మాంటిసోరీస్. టుడే ఐ యామ్ రెడీ టు టీచ్ ద ఆన్లైన్ క్లాస్ టు 10th క్లాస్ సోషల్ సబ్జెక్ట్ ఆన్ ద లెసన్ ద క్లైమేట్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా. What is the difference between weather and climate? Weather is an atmospheric condition to an area at a particular time. That means it has changes time to time. The variations we can observe within a short period in atmospheric condition, that refers to weather. But the climate is different. The climate is the atmospheric condition over a large area which can continue for several years. It may be for 30 years or more than 30 years. If this type of fluctuations we can observe for a long period, this is the reference for climate. I think you can understand the difference between these two. Suppose suddenly there is a change in the atmosphere around us today. If it is cloudy, we have to say that the climate is cloudy is wrong. We have to say that the weather has changed. If it is high temperatures are recording, we have to say that it is the hot weather. We should not use climate for this short term changes. Next, what are the elements that can affect the weather and climate of a place? They are temperature, atmospheric pressure, wind, humidity and precipitation. So these are the elements of weather and climate. So let me explain clearly about these. Temperature. What is temperature? The degree of hotness and coldness is called temperature. Next, atmospheric pressure. The pressure exerted by the atmosphere is called atmospheric pressure. The next one, wind. Moving air is called wind. Humidity. The invisible water vapor present in the atmosphere is called humidity. Next, precipitation. Precipitation is the different forms of condensation like fog, dew. We can say that there are different forms of condensation. Comes under the category of precipitation. So temperature, atmospheric pressure, wind, humidity and precipitation are the elements of weather and climate. The elements of the weather and climate can be shown through pictures. They are called climographs or climatographs. The pictures which can show the elements of weather and climate, they are called climographs or climatographs. Here I am going to show the pictures of climatographs of different areas in India. One is the New Delhi. Next one, second one is the Leh. Third one is the Jaipur. And the last one is the Chennai. So what did you observe in these climographs? You can observe the mean, maximum and minimum temperatures along with the range of rainfall. So these pictures are depicting the annual rainfall conditions along with the temperature levels also. So what did you observe in these four places? We can observe the wide variations in all these climographs. Why? Because India has different land masses. So because of its varied relief features, there are differences can be observed in these areas. If you take New Delhi, New Delhi is the place of inland. Inland means this is a place which is at the center of the country. That is mainly it is in the middle area, middle part of our country. Then coming to Leh. Leh is a place of the Himalayas. Then Jaipur. Jaipur is the capital of Rajasthan. That is desert area. Next, Chennai. Chennai is comes to the place of the coastal area. So here these are the four places that depict the variations in the temperature levels, which leads to the changes in the climatic conditions also. Coming to New Delhi, it is as it is center place, it is far away from the sea coast also, and it is completely surrounded by the land area. So here New Delhi experience hot, very hotness, that is during the summer. At the same time, there is very low levels of temperature also be found during the winter season. So like that, much variations can be observed in the levels of temperature in New Delhi. Coming to the Leh. Leh is a place of mountainous region. So in this place, as this place is on the higher altitude region, it is very cool area. Coming to the Jaipur, it is a desert region. We can find the arid climate here. That means days are very hot and nights are very cold. Coming to Chennai, Chennai is a place, it is the capital of Tamil Nadu, where it experience equatable climate. Equatable climate means as this place is near to the seacoast region, much variations are not found in the temperature levels throughout the year. So this type of climatic conditions are example for equatable climate. So like that, these four climatographs are revealing the wide variations in the temperature levels. So let me explain about what are the factors that can affect the climate of a place. Factors that affect the climate of a place. They are latitude or distance from the equator, relief, land and water relationship, and upper air circulation. So there are four factors that affect the climate of a place. So let me explain clearly one after another. The first one is latitude. What is a latitude? The horizontal imaginary lines on the globe are called latitudes. These latitudes are helpful to know the temperature of a place. So sun is a source of heat and light. We receive the heat and light from the sun. The amount of heat we receive, it should be given back to the earth also, given back to atmosphere also. So this is called insolation. The amount of heat that can be that is giving back to the atmosphere is called insolation. But this absorption of the heat can divide the earth into some zones. It mainly depends upon the curvature of the earth, because earth is in the spherical shape. As we observe that the central part, which can receive the 100 units of the sunlight, and as we further move from the central portion to, that is to the higher altitude areas, this temperature decreases, because as it receives less units of hotness from the sun. So this is because of the curvature of the earth. See, here I am showing the small one here. Suppose if this is the earth, you can see this curvature coming to the central portion, as this is the equator. Equator is a 0 degrees latitude. So you can observe that as it is parallel to the sun, it receives more solar energy. Like that, if you move further from the equator, the temperature decreases as it receives less solar energy because of its curvature. Okay, that means here sun rays are falling on a slanting way. Here it is parallel. So this curvature is making the earth to get to find the variations in receiving the sunlight from the sun. So depending upon that, the earth can be divided into different zones. Depending on that temperature, it can be divided into three zones. They are tropical zone, temperate zone and polar zone. Where is tropical zone? This tropical zone is also called as the equatorial region. Either side of the equator comes under tropical zone, and this is also be called as equatorial region. Then above the tropical zone there is temperate zone, then above the temperate zone there is polar zone. So what are the important latitudes that can divide these zones are 0 degrees latitude is called the equator, 2300 degrees north latitude is called Tropic of Cancer, 2300 degrees south latitude is called the Tropic of Capricorn, and 6600 degrees north latitude is the Arctic Circle, 6600 degrees south latitude is called Antarctic Circle. So depending on the temperature, it is divided into three zones. But depending on the climate, these zones are divided as four. They are tropical zone, subtropical zone, temperate zone and polar zone. The next factor is land and water relationship. Land and water relationship also contribute the climate of a place. That it affects the climate of a place. Generally, the formation of land breeze and sea breeze we can observe in the areas where the land is close to the water body. In the areas of coastal region, as the land is nearby the water body, what happens during the daytime, sea breeze is formed, that is cold breeze is formed. At the same time, night time, the land breeze is formed because of the low pressure and high pressure created by the air. So here we have to see the what are the good reflectors and what are the good absorbers of the heat. Coming to the places of highly vegetated ones, that means the places which have more plants and trees, generally that tent is to be good absorbers. They can absorb the heat. But coming to the snow covered areas, so their tent is to be the reflectors. They can reflect fast. Here coming to land and water, the land can absorb the heat and leaves the heat fast. But it is different to water. Water can absorb the heat and loses the heat slowly. So this activity can make the formation of land breeze and sea breeze, which can affect the climate of the coastal region. Because of this interaction, the coastal regions experience equitable climate. Equitable climate means much variations are not found in the temperature levels throughout the year. So that's why I have showed an example in the climatographs of Chennai. There we can observe that less variations are found in the range of temperature throughout the year. The next one is relief feature. The relief also one of the factor that can affect the climate of a place. The temperature decreases at the altitude of every 1000 meters is 6.4 degrees Celsius. There is a decrease of 6.4 degrees Celsius temperature at every 1000 meters. So like that, there are some places in India, even though in peak summers, they remain cool. Some of the places are Shimla, Gulmarg, Nainital and Darjeeling in Himalayas. Next one, in South India, Kodaikanal and Ooty. So Ooty also known as Udagamandalam. Ooty is in Tamil Nadu on the hills of Nilgiris. The hills of Nilgiris, Udagamandalam is the hill station which remains cool even in peak summers. Here I want to say one more point here, that is, if you observe South India and North India, why the North India remains cooler as compared to South India? The temperature of the North India is low as compared to South India. What is the reason? Many of us thinking that because of the presence of Himalayas, but that is not correct. Why? There is a latitude which passes through the middle of the India, that is 2300 degrees north latitude, that is Tropic of Cancer. Earlier I have mentioned you that the distance from the equator can affect the temperature of a place. As we move further from the equator, the temperature decreases. If you observe like that, what is the position of India? The North India comes to the place of temperate zone and the South India comes to the place of tropical zone. Then which one is near to the equator? That is, the South India is in the place of tropical zone which experience high temperatures as compared to North India. So due to this reason, the North Indian climate is cooler as compared to South India. Okay, next one. You have seen the relief features also. Some areas, as because of their altitudinal position, as we move up, then the temperature decreases. The clear examples I have mentioned you here, Himalayas are the mountainous region, as because of their higher altitudinal pattern makes these places to be very cool even in the peak summers. So like that, some of the places I have mentioned here, Kodaikanal and Ooty, generally these two are the places of South India, as the South India has high temperatures as compared to North India. These two places I have mentioned as very cool areas because of their altitudinal place, that is their altitude, because they are on the higher altitudes. Both Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats meet at Nilgiris. In that, the famous hill station is Ooty. Because of its higher altitude, it remains cool even in the peak summer. The another factor is upper air circulation. We have seen the zones on our earth depending upon the temperature and climate. Coming to the climate, depending upon the climatic conditions, these zones can be divided as four: subtropical, tropical, temperate and polar zone. Here, the movement of air also can affect the, it also can affect the climate of a place. Because the winds blowing from one zone to another can reflect on the climate of that place. So like that, if you find trade winds and jet streams. What are trade winds? The winds that blow from subtropical high pressure belt to tropical belt, as they move in one direction, particularly after reaching for some time, constantly they move in one direction, westerly direction. So those winds are called trade winds. In the same way, jet streams. jet streams are formed at 25 degrees north latitude. These are upper air currents. So these upper air currents, they form at 25 degrees north latitudes, which can make the neighboring areas to become cool. So because of the effect of trade winds and jet streams, it can affect the climate of our country. So do you know where is our India? Our India is in the northern hemisphere. It comes to the which zone? That is dry northeast trade winds. Depending upon its climatic conditions, it comes to the trade winds of dry northeast trade winds. Like that, trade winds and jet streams affect the climate of our country. So there are wide variations in our country, as some areas are at high altitude, some areas are plateau regions, some areas are comes under the plain regions, some areas comes under the dry region. Like that, depending upon its physiographic areas or relief features, our India is experiencing wide variations in the climatic conditions. So depending upon these wide variations, we have seasons in a year: winter, summer, and rainy or monsoon. So depending upon these, we can experience wide variations in the climatic conditions in different areas. The upper air currents are known as jet streams. They form at 12,000 meters high at the speed of 110 kilometers per hour in summer, because they are the fast flowing currents. In summer, they blow with the speed of 110 kilometers per hour, but in winter they blow at the speed of 184 kilometers per hour. So like that, the blow of jet streams affect the climate of India. So depending upon the variations in the climatic conditions, the seasons known of a country. So like that, in India we have monsoonal winds. We have two sets of monsoonal winds that blow from Arabian Sea branch and Bay of Bengal branch. So like that, Himalayas, the presence of Himalayas can affect the climate of India. Like that, we have some questions related to these topics. So in the first lesson, the relief features, we have an important question: what is the influence of Himalayas on Indian climate, and what is the influence of Himalayas on Indian agriculture also? So for that question, you have to write that Himalayas are contributing a lot to the Indian agriculture, because they are the reason for getting the monsoonal rains, and they are the barriers in protecting the India from the cold winds that are rising from Central Asia. Like that, they are the source of perennial rivers. In the same way, we can say the climatic conditions in the South India, that is moderate climatic conditions or equitable climatic conditions in the coastal region. Then some of the questions related to this topic: what is the difference between weather and climate? Next, what are the elements of weather and climate? What are the factors that contribute to the climate of your place? Next, I have mentioned some places through climatographs or climographs. So what did you observe there? One place is on the mountainous region, one is in the inland area. Inland means what? Which is surrounded by the land, which is far away from the land also. That comes to the inland, where extreme temperatures are to be recorded as compared to other areas. Like that, I have mentioned there Delhi, and you have seen the Jaipur. That is, it has an arid climate. Next, coming to equatorial climate, the place of Chennai is revealing the moderate climatic conditions. Suppose if a question is asked you that why the climate of Chennai is moderate or equatable, why don't we find the much variations in the temperature throughout the year? What do we tell about jet streams? Next, what do you say about tropical and subtropical zones? Like that, how does the curvature of the earth affect the temperature on our earth surface? So like that, various questions can be asked regarding this topic. So depending upon the weightage of the question, we have to give the answer.
Ullampur Monsoon School గత నెల రోజుల నుంచి ఆన్లైన్ క్లాసులు చాలా సమర్థవంతంగా నిర్వహిస్తుంది. 10th క్లాస్ విద్యార్థులతో పాటు అన్ని తరగతుల వారికి బ్రిడ్జ్ కోర్స్ నిర్వహించారు. వాటి డిజి క్లాసులు కావచ్చు, ఇటు ఆన్లైన్ క్లాసులు కావచ్చు. పాలకుల్లో మొట్టమొదటిసారి ఏర్పాటు చేసిన ఘనత మన ఉల్లంపూర్ మాండ్సూరికి దక్కుతుంది. మారుతున్న కాలానికి అనుగుణంగా నూతన విద్యా విధానాన్ని అనుసరిస్తూ ఎప్పటికప్పుడు మాండ్సూర్ స్కూల్ వన్ ఆఫ్ ది బెస్ట్ స్కూల్గానే నిలబడుతుంది. ఉల్లంపూర్ మాండ్సూర్ స్కూల్ అంటే ఏదో ఎక్కడో ఉన్నటువంటి బ్రాండ్ స్కూల్ పేరు చెప్పి ఇక్కడ రన్ చేయట్లేదు. అదేవిధంగానే ఏదో స్కూల్ని అడాప్ట్ చేసుకుని ఇక్కడ రాలేదు. 30 సంవత్సరాల నుంచి ఒకే మేనేజ్మెంట్ ఆధ్వర్యంలోని అదే క్వాలిటీతో మెయింటైన్ చేస్తున్నది ఉల్లంపూర్ మాండ్సూరియస్. రాబోయే రోజుల్లో ఇలాంటి ఇబ్బంది ఎప్పుడు వచ్చినా కూడా ఆన్లైన్ టూల్స్తో విద్యా బోధన సమర్థవంతంగా చేసే విద్యా సంస్థ మన ఉల్లంపూర్ మాండ్సూర్ స్కూల్. అందుకే ఉల్లంపూర్ మాండ్సూర్ స్కూల్ అంటే తల్లిదండ్రులకు ఓ నమ్మకం, ఓ భరోసా.